Jeeps will carry pilots to the planes. In England, as in Burma or in Italy, General Mud hangs to your feet. And like everything else in every army, the Jeep must carry twice the load it was designed to do. Four pilots ride out to 54 planes. None of them know what lies ahead, but they aren't worried because so far this group has shot down Huns at the rate of 4-for-1. The crew chief helps the pilot into his chute, and crew chiefs worship their planes and their pilots. And they always say, "Good luck, sir, see you later." And sometimes they may say, "How about lending me a pound until tomorrow, boss?" And now the time for start engine year. Six minutes after the first engine starts, the first squadron must begin the takeoff. 7 minutes later, all 54 planes must be airborne. Chiefs ride the wings to guide the pilots into the tight-packed lineup on the runways. Remember, no seconds can be wasted now. These Thunderbolts will need every thimble of gas to get to the target and fight and then get home again today. There goes the flare, and there goes the first pair, like sprinters at the starter's gun. The leader will fly 3 miles out, make a slow turn, and then before he finishes a half turn of the field, the 16 planes of his squadron plus 2 spares must be airborne and in position. The first squadron is off, and the second gets away from the other runway. The third squadron moves into readiness where the first squadron took off 2 minutes ago. One slow climbing turn, all 3 squadrons will assemble and form into a huge V. The lead squadron in the center, the spearhead. The flights fly in a 4-ship V, 8 aircraft operating as a section. The trailing section flying 500 feet above the other. The 2 spares of each squadron straggle behind. Now the whole group sets course on 80 degrees. A slow climb to the Dutch coast, then open up into battle formation. 3 hours from now, home again, if you're lucky. From other fields, other fighter groups take off. Thunderbolts and lightning. In the Battle of Germany, a fighter's first, last, and only job is to protect the bomber. Thunderbolts must climb to high cover positions above the bomber. Climb slow and compact and then open up. Each squadron to its planned position. Throttles are kept pretty well forward, so fighters must weave in orbit to cover the slower bomber. Sometimes our fighters will pull out 5 miles ahead, to break up the frontal attack by the Huns. The Thunderbolts operate like interference in football, taking out the tackle. While they are still climbing, the fighters stay in close. Then it's wide open. The throttles are blasted forward as the combat begins. Bandits are sighted and begin their slashing attacks through the bomber formations, and the Thunderbolts are on top of the attackers. See those two flares? Green, green, distress signal. A bomber needs help. And here come two Thunderbolts. There goes what was a Hun. Pair of the flight. And now a snaky string of lightnings moves into the battle. They are the fighters that cover the bombers on deepest penetrations into Germany. Remember this, you can outdive anything you'll meet in the Battle of Germany. Keep on his tail and in the end you'll get him. Wide open and you gotta reef it in. catch these Huns. The single engine jobs always hit the fortresses from the front. Going into the bombing run, you've really got to protect the bomber, because they've got to fly straight and level through flak and fighters to get their bombs onto the pinpoint targets down below. The opening of the bomb bays is the signal for the bandits to press home their attacks. The bandits know that the forts and libs cannot take evasive action until their bombs are away. The bombardier must forget his nose guns now and concentrate on that bomb site. Through cloud or clear skies, those eggs must go down and find the target. And it's up to you to help the bombers lay those eggs on targets like these. Now the battle moves on. On some missions, all the bombers go for a single target. On other days, several task forces will hammer different targets. Fresh fighter group moves into the scramble. It's hammer, hammer, hammer every mile of the way. Twin-engine Huns come up now with their long-range rocket guns. Watch this explosion. That was a rocketeer. All the bombs are away, the forts and libs must fight their way home again. That's not easy, because many of them are cripples now. And now is when fresh fighter groups speed into the battle to help their big friends get back to Britain. Across the sky that mean fresh fighter strength. Brother, the battered bombers are plenty glad to see it. You see the whole story in these contrails. The broad mass trails are where the bombers turn for home. And there are the single streaking trails that show how the Thunderbolts weave above the homing bombers as top cover. Look at that fort's tail, a 20 millimeter chewed it off. bombers are bound to get it. There goes one of the big boys spinning down. Some of the fighters get it too. There's the single shoot of a Thunderbolt pilot floating down. Many of the men shot down over Germany are still alive, prisoners of war. Smudges of the flak that come up from the anti-aircraft guns below. Battle stays hot as ever through flak and fighters as the forts move on and on to the coast. Sometimes the battle goes on halfway across the channel. Welcome is the sight of the coast of England. But even then, the battle is not ended, because crippled planes must still be landed, and often that is not easy. The battle-damaged fighters limp home to land ahead of their group. Watch this landing. His right tire is shot away. Hold it. And at last, he's down. And now a group of lightnings land. Group comes home. Flight after flight will peel off. A new flight moves into peel off position as each proceeding flight goes into the approach. To down in close order. They must clear the end of the field as fast as possible. Taxis to its own hard standing, widely dispersed around the field. To their planes, now take them back to the interrogation.